In our summer series, American Wonders, we're exploring places that make our country wonderful, from majestic natural landscapes to spectacular creations. This morning, we take you to a Tennessee cave for a tour of the largest underground lake in America. It attracts about 2,000 visitors a day from all over the world. Chip Reid went 140 feet below ground to see it.
Good morning, and get ready for an adventure. What you do is walk down this yellow tunnel, then you take a long, circuitous path through a beautiful underground cavern, and you arrive directly underneath me at the largest underground lake in the Northern Hemisphere. And yes, they call it the Lost Sea.
Deep in the foothills of the Smoky Mountains, about 50 miles south of Knoxville, sits an American wonder, 140 feet below ground. Inside, a narrow tunnel leads to an intricate cave system drenched in history. Cherokee Indians used it as a shelter in the 1820s.
This is actually authentic writing from the Civil War.
And during the Civil War, Confederate soldiers used the cave's minerals to make gunpowder.
So you remember this from your childhood?
Yes, I was actually 6 years old the first time I came down here with my grandmother and my older brother.
Tour guide Savannah Dalton is part of that rich history. Her grandmother and great aunt played down here as children.
We're actually making our way towards the lake room.
That cave system leads to the main tourist attraction, the lake.
The lake was discovered by Ben Sands, a 13-year-old boy who had actually crawled through a tunnel that was the size of a bicycle tire for 40 feet before he dropped down into the lake itself and actually waded out into about knee-deep water. It was, of course, a lot smaller when he came through, but we've blasted it out since.
Here it is, everyone.
Because of his discovery, the Lost Sea Adventure now sees about 150,000 tourists a year from all over the world.
Did you have fun? Yeah. High fives all around.
A boat ferries visitors across the clear water.
Bon voyage.
Where you can dip your fingers in the cold lake.
Feel that 56 degree water.
It is chilly.
And watch rainbow trout swim by.
How many fish do you have in here?
Close to 300, all rainbow trout. So they're down here long enough that they do lose a small portion of both their eyesight and their color. So the lighting, of course, it's not natural sunlight, so they can't really maintain that pigment.
The water is at least 70 feet deep and covers 4.5 acres.
What are those white streaks over there?
This is a formation known as drapery, and it's actually where water is leaching the iron out of the rock, and then it'll hang down and form what we see there. A lot of people also call it cave bacon.
Any idea how long a piece of cave bacon like that has been forming?
Oh, probably hundreds, if not thousands of years.
Wow, that's a long time to wait for bacon.
Dalton says she enjoys her job just as much today as when she started more than 7 years ago.
What's the best part of what you do?
So there's a rich history here, and it's something that you don't get to see every day. So just seeing the awe and the wonder in people's faces when they come in and see this for the first time, it's pretty amazing.
So if you find yourself in the general vicinity of eastern Tennessee, you might want to stop by and check out this American wonder. I'm Chip Reid with my illustrious guide, Savannah Dalton, 140 feet below Sweetwater, Tennessee.
I like that word, illustrious guide, Savannah Dalton.
That is some sweet,
nice.
That is some sweet water. It's so clear down there now.
Very, very nice.
Really beautiful.
They don't let you fish, though, I guess, so the fish look pretty catchable.
Yeah, they do look.
They actually look very doable. Very doable.
Might go, Gayle?
Yeah, I won't be so scared.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Chip Reid, and illustrious guide, Savannah Dalton. Like her, too.
I see a field trip ahead.
I'd like that. All right.